If you're moving to Windows 8 from Windows 7, you might notice that Windows looks a little different. I'd like to show you that you can do all the same things you've always done before. In fact, you might notice that Windows 8 isn't really so different. In this video, we'll explain the Start screen, launching and finding applications, the charm bar, printing, Wi-Fi, navigating between applications, Toshiba Central, Internet Explorer 10, desktop mode, and recovery options. If you have a second computer or other device with which you can view this video, feel free to follow along on your Windows 8 laptop. When you power on the laptop, Windows will load the Start screen or lock screen, depending on your settings. Personally, I notice that Windows 8 loads much faster than Windows 7. The lock screen shows the date, time, and other notifications. You can press any key to raise the lock screen. If your account is password protected, you type it here. Then the Windows Start screen will be displayed. On the Start screen, you'll see various rectangles called tiles. In Windows 7, shortcuts launch your programs. In Windows 8, you'll launch programs using tiles. This might look different, but do you see the tile labeled Desktop? Click on it to see the Windows 8 Desktop mode. This probably looks more familiar to you. I'll tell you more about Desktop mode later. For now, press the Windows key on your keyboard to return to the Start screen. It's likely that you'll have too many tiles to see all of them at once. You can scroll left and right by dragging the scroll bar along the bottom left or right. If you're using an external mouse, you can also use the scroll wheel. Scrolling the wheel up and down scrolls the Start screen left and right. Some of your less commonly used programs might not have tiles on the Start screen. To see all of your programs, right-click on the Start screen's background to open a panel at the bottom. Then click All Apps. You'll see all your applications here. Don't forget that you can scroll using the scroll bar along the bottom. Press the Windows key again to return to the Start screen. Searching for applications is very easy. Just start typing. To find the weather application, start by typing the letter W at the Start screen, and Windows will instantly show the search results screen. Type the rest of the word weather. It should find one result, the weather application. Hit Enter to run it. Now press the Windows key to return to the Start screen. Many features, including commonly used settings, are in a new feature called the charm bar. To view this bar, move your cursor to the upper right of the screen and bring the cursor down over the bar. You can also press the C button while holding the Windows key to open the charm bar. The charm bar is context sensitive. This means that what the charms do depends on what application you're currently using. Click on Search to see the search feature again that we saw earlier. If you'd like to search for a file or setting instead of an application, select Files or Settings on the right of the search results screen instead. If you were to open an application, such as the Finance app, open the charm bar, and click Search, you'd be searching in that specific application. Return to the Start screen and click Internet Explorer. Open the charm bar again and click the Devices charm. This will allow you to send the active content to another device. If you had a printer connected, you'd be able to print from here. You can also select Settings in the charm bar. Above the line, you'll see context-sensitive settings. This time, these refer to Internet Explorer settings because it's the application that I'm currently using. Below the line are settings that refer to the computer and are always present. Of these six settings, the button on the top left is for Wi-Fi. Clicking this will allow you to connect to any detected Wi-Fi network. Simply click a network name to connect to a network. Let's go back to look at the other settings. The top middle button is for volume and will show a volume slider. Click and drag it up or down to change the volume. The top right button is for brightness and works just like the volume button. The bottom left button allows you to hide notifications. The bottom middle button is for power. Click it to see shutdown options. Sleep will put the computer in a low power mode. Shutdown turns the computer off using a new mode intended to speed up starting next time. Restart will restart Windows, offering a fresh instance of Windows. Because of the new method Windows uses to shut down, if you have a problem or install something that requires you to restart, don't just shut down the computer and then start it again. Make sure to use Restart. Below those six buttons, you'll see Change PC Settings. Click this. Many basic settings can be changed from here. For example, you could change the lock screen or start screen. Now let's learn how to quickly change applications. Press and hold the Windows key. While holding it, repeatedly tap the Tab key. This will cycle through the various open applications. Let go of the Windows key to switch to the selected application. If you move your cursor to the upper left of the screen, you'll see a thumbnail of the last application you used. Click to open it again. You could also move the cursor down rather than clicking on it to see thumbnails of all your open applications. Right-click on an application and select Close to close that application. If you'd like to learn more about your laptop, you could check your user's guide that's part of Toshiba Central. If you have trouble finding it, remember that you can simply type Toshiba Central to search for it. Toshiba Central displays your laptop's model number, part number, serial number, user's guide, and other support material, including how-to videos and forums. Now let's take a look at Internet Explorer. From the Start screen, click on the Internet Explorer tile. In previous versions of Internet Explorer, the address bar was at the top. Now, the web page is full screen. Right-click on the page to view Internet Explorer's interface, with the address bar at the bottom. Click in the address bar, type support.toshiba.com, and press Enter to navigate to our support site. Click anywhere on the page that's not a link to hide the interface. Now, right-click on the background to show the interface once more. The back button is to the left of the address bar, and the forward button is on the far right. To the right of the address bar is the refresh button. Next to that is a button that looks like a pin. Click it. If you choose Pin to Start, a shortcut to the Toshiba support site will appear on the Start screen as a tile. Instead, select Add to Favorites. Click in the address bar again, but this time don't type anything. You'll see your frequently accessed sites above the address bar. To the right, you'll see your favorites. To see more, move your cursor over to see the scroll bar and scroll to the right. To remove a favorite, right-click it and select Remove. To open a bookmark, simply click it. Right-click on the background to open the interface again. At the top, you'll notice a thumbnail. This is a tab. Click the plus sign button at the upper right to open a new tab. You can also hold the Control key and press the T key to open a new tab. Earlier I said we'd look more at desktop mode later. You've already learned about the parts of Windows that change the most, so now we'll look at desktop mode. Hold the Windows key and press the D key. This takes you directly to desktop mode. Using that key combination is the same as selecting the desktop tile. Desktop mode looks very similar to Windows 7. Applications that were designed for Windows 7 and not Windows 8 will be run in this desktop mode. In addition, some software specifically designed for Windows 8 might be designed for Windows 8 desktop mode. The volume and Wi-Fi icons are still in the notification area near the clock at the bottom right. If you click on the Wi-Fi icon, you'll notice that it opens the same network section we saw earlier in the charm bar. The charm bar is still accessible from desktop mode. Click on the desktop to close the charm bar. Then, click the folder icon on the taskbar to open the File Explorer, which used to be called Windows Explorer. Now, move the cursor to the top left to view other output applications. This, along with the Windows key and Tab key combination, will still allow you to see open applications. You might notice that the open folder doesn't show up there. This list only shows applications designed for the new style of Windows 8. Applications that run in desktop mode won't be displayed in that way. You can hold the Alt button and repeatedly press Tab to cycle through all open applications, both new style and desktop mode. Click the Internet Explorer icon at the bottom on the taskbar. You'll notice that this looks very different than the Internet Explorer we saw earlier. This is the desktop mode Internet Explorer and functions like Internet Explorer did in Windows 7. One change you might notice about desktop mode is that there's no Start button. You might wonder how to find your applications without a Start button or Start menu, but it's actually quite simple. Press the Windows key to return to the Start screen. You can right-click a tile and select Pin to Taskbar at the bottom if it's a desktop mode application to place a shortcut to that application on the taskbar. Sometimes you might need to perform administrative tasks. Hold the Windows key and press the X button. A menu will open at the bottom left of the screen with many administrative tasks. Click Control Panel. This contains many settings. You might recognize it from Windows 7. Open the Windows X menu again and select Power Options. From here, you can choose various power options, such as what closing the lid or pressing the power button does. Open the Windows X menu again and select Task Manager. This shows you a list of running applications. You can use this if an application misbehaves and needs to be closed. Let's try it. First, I'll open Calculator. Then I'll go back to the Task Manager, select Windows Calculator, and then click the End Task button. It's closed. Now click the More Details button. This is more advanced, but looks closer to the Task Manager from Windows 7. Advanced users might want to note that the Startup tab controls startup items, and that the Services tab can be used to manage services. The final thing I'd like to show you is what to do if you're having problems. Open the Charm Bar, click Settings, and click Power. Then hold the Shift key and select Restart. You'll see a screen with Continue, Troubleshoot, and Turn off your PC. Click Troubleshoot. Now click Advanced Options. The most commonly used tool is System Restore. It lets you roll back the system files on your computer without removing any of your personal data. Click the back arrow. Refresh your PC is another useful tool. This will keep your files, personalization settings, and new style applications purchased from the Windows Store. Your PC settings will be changed back to their defaults, and desktop mode applications that were downloaded or installed from disks will be removed. Congratulations! You now have all the information you need to use Windows 8 for your entertainment or productivity tasks. Let us know in the comments what additional videos you'd like to see. For more information, visit support.toshiba.com.